In this video, I'll introduce you to the model view controller design pattern in Rails. Hi, this is Asia G from the Full Stack Videos channel. To understand the structure and organization of a Rails web application, you'll need to understand the model view controller concept. I explain it in this video. Let's talk about a simple web request. When you click a link in a web page or enter a URL in a web browser, the browser makes a request to the web server and waits for a response. The server responds by delivering files. It's always files. Even if it's a web application built with Rails, the web server returns an HTML file and maybe CSS or JavaScript files too. That's the basic request response cycle. In the early days of the web, researchers explored ways to use computer programs to compose files to be sent as a response from web servers. A URL would trigger a program that would generate a file. Each program might access a database, make calculations, and generate or render an HTML file. Different URLs would trigger different programs. In the mid-1990s, researchers looked at ways to write larger single programs that would respond to multiple URLs. Instead of duplicating code for accessing a database or generating a file, all the code could be consolidated in one program. To make it work, part of the program would handle routing, which would let one program generate different web pages depending on the URL. Now, researchers had one big program that consolidated all the code in one place, but the program was large and doing several different things. At this point, developers became concerned about ease of maintenance and collaboration and issues of software architecture. Software architecture is about organizing code for easier maintenance and collaboration. Computer scientists talk about separation of concerns. So researchers looked at ways to organize a web application program and borrowed ideas from the architecture of desktop applications, where programs often use the model view controller design pattern. This is what a web application program looks like when code is organized with a model view controller design pattern. Web applications need a router to map URLs to different controllers. So the design pattern actually is router controller model view. If you ask a Rails developer to draw a diagram of model view controller, this may be what they show you. It's a typical MVC diagram you'll see in other videos or books. But actually, in Rails, this diagram is more accurate. Rails has a single router that handles multiple URL requests, and a typical Rails application has multiple controllers, models, and views. It's up to you how you organize your features with multiple models, controllers, and views. That's the art of building a Rails application. Let's talk about the different parts of a model view controller design. All the code that accesses a database or manages data belongs in the model. All the code that forms the HTML page, including layout and page content, goes in the view. The controller responds to the browser request. The controller is like a conveyor belt in a factory that processes a web request and produces a web response. There is a sequence of steps and sometimes logic to perform different actions. Usually, the controller selects one or more models that contain data. There may be logic that controls access, like forcing a user to log in. Finally, the controller selects which views will be used to render the web page. In Rails, the model view controller design is conceptual, as a way to think about your code, and also practical, as a way to organize your code. One of the reasons Rails is popular is because it provides a consistent structure. So code gets organized into folders according to the model view controller design pattern. If you look at any Rails applications, you'll see folders for model view and controller files. Let's look at the Full Stack Videos website. Here is a page that is only seen by an administrator. It shows a list of videos. We call it the Videos Index page. Here is another page that shows details about a specific video. We call it a video show page. Let's look at the code for the Full Stack Videos app. Here is the app directory that contains folders for controllers, models, and views. In the models folder, there is a model file for a video. It contains code that defines a video object. The video class inherits from the application record class, which inherits from active record, so the video object will contain data from the database. In the controllers folder, there is a videos controller file. The videos controller inherits from the application controller class and the action controller class, so it knows how to handle web requests and render views. The videos controller can generate several different pages. There is an action or method called index and another called show, as well as several others. The Rails routing file routes URLs according to certain conventions. If the URL contains just videos, the videos controller index method will process the web request. The first thing it does is set a variable named videos with a collection of videos from the database. Our code orders the list by descending date and does some pagination. It uses video model class to do so, relying on methods that are inherited from the active record class. After the videos collection is created, the videos controller will render an index view. We don't see any code for the rendering because it is Rails magic. By convention, the action controller class automatically renders an index view when the index action is called. There is also a show method or action that the router triggers when the application receives a request for a different URL. The show method also uses the video model, this time to retrieve data about a single video from the database, finding it by using an ID parameter. Then it accesses the database to retrieve a list of related videos. We don't see any code that is used to access the database because it is handled by the video model's active record interface. That is separation of concerns in action, because our controller code is brief and simple and not cluttered with any code that is required for database access. After we have a video variable and a collection of related videos, the show method will render a show page. Again, it's Rails magic, and we don't see any code that actually generates a file to be sent to the web browser. Let's look in the views directory. We'll see a folder of views that are used by the videos controller. Let's look at the code in the videos index view file. The views files are the only place you'll see HTML code in a Rails application. There's some HTML code to create a table showing collection of videos. This is an ERB file with embedded Ruby code mixed in with the HTML code. You can see we have some Ruby code that iterates through a collection of videos, displaying various attributes of a video from the database, such as date, difficulty level, title, and description. This is basic software engineering. Principles like separation of concerns and well-known design patterns like model view controller give organization and structure to our code. It makes it easier to collaborate on the code with other developers and to maintain it over time. Though the concepts are abstract, we can see the practical result in the files and folders of our Rails project. And understanding the concept helps us understand how the code is organized in a Rails application. This is really all you need to know about Model View Controller to get started building a Rails application. If you're a subscriber, I'd like to say I appreciate your support for the project. To get more videos like this and learn about our project, send me an email. The address is more@fullstackvideos.com. Come back for more!